got something for you to buy now. Something cool, something new, something for you to try now. I know you're feeling low, but I'm gonna get you high now. Now that you're high, take your clothes off and lie down. Smoking reefer, got her open, now she open. We got high, she said. You smoking reefer, I got her sipping, now she dripping. Come listen. Yeah, I can be your E-pill, better yet your D-pill. When it come to tricking D-pill, she say that my pipe is cracking, you know that I'm gon' get very ill. So I just penetrate and hit her with my needle. She need deals to stay alive, keep my crack in between her thighs. When she smokes, she feel her high, say it's good enough to make her cry.
I think she need new lungs, cause my bitch she get.
Smoking reefer, got her open, now she open. We got high, she said. You smoking reefer, I got her sipping, now she dripping.
Why you need a pusher? No, you need a pusher. Get it how you living when you know you need the hooker. I can get it quicker. No, I got you shook up.
I'm your pusher, but I don't be on no corner. Put me in your nose, inhale my aroma. Shit so potent, shit stronger than ammonia. OD and fucked around and slipped into a coma. She said, you smoking reefer. Got her open, now she open. We got high. She said, you smoking reefer. I got her sipping, now she dripping. We got high. She said, smoking reefer, got her open, now she open. We got high, she said. We smoking reefer, I got her sipping, now she dripping.
Materials,
dripping.
Check.
Happy Monday, y'all. Happy Cozy Monday, y'all.
Boys.
As far as that ASAP Rocky is concerned, like, I always wanted to have an internet show where that was my recurring intro music. That track, I think it makes for a good intro. And, I don't know. Maybe just, like, cut the first, like, 45 seconds from it. I'm gonna have to hit up Atlantic Records for whoever the hell that is. Owns the rights to that. I want the first 45 seconds to be the intro for this show. Come on, dog!
One of them over there.
Reloading. Tango
Nice, 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 nice.
I'm back. Logged off my drone.
Reload. Give my shields a recharge.
Oh, they're screwed.
Enemy down.
Oh! That's how it's done. That's how it's done!
A coordinated assault. Perfectly.
The first round went bad. You must remain hopeful. You must carry on in faith. I am a big fan of the Spitfire. I must admit. Okay. Okay, I'll try to drone them out again. I'm just gonna hang back and drone them. Don't get killed, right?
Taking an extra pair of eyes.
So play kind of defensively, because I can always come and back you up, you know what I mean? Like, just don't get tagged.
Oscar Mike, spotted. Reloading.
I'm back. Logged off my drone.
Careful if you're gonna res me, dude.
Plenty of
fire. Get down. Need a medic.
Close to winning.
Gonna get into some market analysis and stuff like that in just a little bit here.
Putting an eye in the
but
sky.
I just
secured some materials.
I just think that everybody should appreciate the programming on behalf of
this fire.
Backing out of my drone. I'm good to go.
Incoming. Y'all
learned this.
Just watch your back.
Off the mic. They got me. I'm
down.
Reloading.
Yeah. We got company, people.
I'm charging my shield.
I say, you are in my way.
The winner is decided. I'd almost call this a prize.
was listening to Warren Buffett just for a little bit. It's funny how Warren Buffett is the definitive old man. Like, everything that he talks about is always about how long he's been trading for. He's the definitive old man commentary on the market. And here you go. I've said many times that there are people who reject technology. There are people who are not willing to get on board with the modern and stuff. Warren Buffett is that. He is just that. If you look at the Berkshire Hathaway website, it's like a website from 20 years ago. It's like HTML and like text. And that's the website. But it's also a demonstration of the validity of that position in the validity of that that nature in relation to the market. You know, like he's by no means not able to achieve amazingly good profitable ends taking that approach. So there's that balance. I just think the reason that I'm tech interested, number one, according to science, if we can implement the technology that we have, it will be to great advantage. And I think the alternative perspective, like the Warren Buffett perspective, is, oh, if we reject the ultra-modern, if we reject the technology, then we'll discover things about traditional modes that will be just as valid. And I think in many ways, there's a great integrity to that. Like, there is... One must acknowledge that Warren Buffett has achieved such substantial ends through time, yes, but also through very stark business practices, like a holding company, or like creating a stock market index. Those two things, I mean, they're by no means innovative at all. It's just like a business approach to business, and his wealth definitely is comparable to that of Elon Musk, who's trying to do dangerous and impossible things. Somebody was just saying on Facebook that I was looking at the problems with, or I was just kind of going over the problems with EVs and AI. I walked by a Tesla, a white Tesla that was parked in West Vancouver yesterday, that had a California license plate with AIEV on it. So I left my cards on their car just because I don't see too many like Teslas with AIEV on it, which is kind of interesting. So yeah, I was just talking to somebody on Facebook. Comments, interactions, here we go. Yeah. So, somebody was saying, or they posted this, Elon Musk just now realizing that self-driving cars are a hard problem. Yes, I've been saying this for a while, you know, like, there, and I've said it in previous videos on this YouTube channel, there are many opportunities to implement AI and robotics and automation that are safer than driving a 2-ton car around the street. Like, how about recycling robots that automatically sort landfill materials and recycle it? I don't see that addressed as commonly as the autonomous cars on the road. So this guy said, dude created a private company to put things into space. He's he's credible, you know. So I think, yes, on one side of things, Elon Musk is credible. But on another side of things, you will notice that a lot of what he's pursuing is rather risky for people, such as drilling a hole in your head to put an implant directly into your brain, when you could create other interfaces. You could improve the speech functionality of things like Siri or Cortana or Alexa. There's still a long way to go in making sure that, I mean, if I say to Siri, open up the SoundCloud app and play my weekly playlist, it still can't facilitate that.
right?
So if it can't facilitate that, what makes us think that it's going to be able to drive my car around for me? You know, like if it can't, if we haven't brought the AI to a level where I can say, open up this app on my iPhone and play this artist inside the SoundCloud app. Play ASAP Rocky, Get High inside the SoundCloud app. It can't do that. So why are we going to use it? Like if it can't do that, then why are we going to use it to drive the cars right now when there's other things that we could be doing? So I want an EV, but I don't think I'm going to get a Tesla because I don't even like the idea that Elon Musk, if I say something offensive to him online, can take control of my vehicle as I'm driving it down the highway. You know, there's reason to be apprehensive about that, people. He's going for a lot of power. He wants his personal implants in people's brains, not just on a hat or some kind of interface. Inside the skull is necessary. That's not true. There's other things. There's other nerves. There's other ways. And there are other developers that are developing products that are exactly what I'm talking about that have been on the Lex Fridman podcast. So, yeah, just recently, because he won't go into space, I'm critical of Elon Musk. For anybody that's unaware, I think that Elon Musk should be on the first civilian flight to the space station. Going to the space station is not going to Mars. And if he would go there, I think it would prove that he has some scruples. But I'm not going to buy a Tesla anymore because I don't want Elon Musk to have control over my vehicle. I want an EV. If that Ford... I wonder if the Ford will be an autonomous vehicle. Self-driving technology, or it will have self-driving robotics as part of the vehicle. There's a new Ford truck that's an EV. I'd probably go for that new Ford EV just because I definitely, this is how I'm feeling right now. I just feel like when all is said and done, Elon's stuff, it's dangerous. And it's not. And there's other opportunities other than that. So, here we go. Overpromising and underdelivering. Finally, people are starting to be critical of Musk. Because I think it's due. So, let's see what this whole article has to say here. His birth, he's a Gemini, I think. I think he's a Gemini. Or is he Cancer? Anyway, we're born around the same time. I'm born on June 22nd. He's born 6 days later.
Elon Musk just now realizing that self-driving cars are a hard problem. 21. Tesla CEO Elon Musk is finally admitting that he underestimated how difficult it is to develop a safe and reliable self-driving car. To which the entire engineering community rose up as one to say, no duh. Or at least that's how it should have happened in a just world. Instead, all the Tesla sycophants and ass-kissers on Twitter told Musk to keep up the good work, that they believed in him, and encouraged him to hurry up and roll out the latest version of his full self-driving software that, it's worth pointing out, does not enable a Tesla vehicle to drive itself without input from the driver. Musk has a long history of overpromising and underdelivering. Musk has a long history of overpromising and underdelivering when it comes to his company's so-called full self-driving software. He did it in 2018, when he promised that the long-awaited V9, version 9, would begin rolling out in August.
Well, perhaps he's doing these development, pursuing these development-specific aspects, because he thinks that's what people want. And maybe that's true. People do want that. They want to go that far. They want to ride that edge. But with PayPal, I think there's another kind of, you know, reason to be apprehensive in that it was one of the first companies online that would solicit your information and provide a reliable third-party intermediary payment system. So I don't know, man. It's not Jeff Bezos allowing me to order Jesus muscle shirts effortlessly at a good price. That's something that I can... There's no risk to me unless And I found that Amazon is providing very good return policy. If I order something on Amazon and it's not what I wanted, the return policy works. I get my money back. It's a good store. So, do I own any of Elon Musk's products? No, I don't own a Tesla. I wanted a Tesla for a long time, but now that I've started to think more and more about it, I'm now apprehensive.
August. He did it again in 2019, proclaiming that a year from now, there would be over a million cars with full self-driving, software, everything.
That's kind of true. I think that all of the Teslas that are produced, have been produced over the past couple of years, they all have the robotics. They have the physical ability to self-drive. But policy.
He was back at it again this past weekend, promising that FSD 9 beta is shipping soon, with an added, I swear, just in case you had any doubts about his solemnity. There's no question that Tesla is more willing than its competitors to test beta versions of its autopilot driver assist feature on its customers in the interest of gathering data and working out any bugs in the system. And Tesla customers are mostly fine with this, routinely flooding Musk's mentions begging to be whitelisted for the current version of full self-driving. This has helped contribute to Tesla's public reputation as a leader in autonomous driving.
Well, just to mention it, personally, I would probably side with what Tesla is doing rather than Comma AI to what George Hotz is doing, just because I think it would be safer. I think it would be safer to trust your Tesla than to trust George Hotz. I mean, if something happened in your Tesla, at least you'd have somebody to sue. I'm not sure how much capital George Hotz is sitting on, but if it kills my family or makes me into quadriplegic, there better be some capital assets that I can then sue for.
Driving, despite its vehicles continuously falling short of what most experts would agree defines a self-driving car. Tesla says autopilot is safe. It releases quarterly reports with selectively reported data that it says proves this, but that it also requires constant input from the driver in order to work.
The one thing that I'm thinking of is that I'm not sure if there is a specific department within the government that is or that has been or is being developed that would keep tabs on this specific niche, because I think there needs to be that pressure on them, like the Department of AI Research and Development, or just because, I mean, like, who's giving us the data? Like, who's collecting the data and who's giving us the info? It's the developer itself. So obviously they're going to say that it's safer and that things are going well, and that whenever something does not go well, like a Tesla straight up murders somebody by careening off the highway. And I've talked to my friend who owns a Tesla, my buddy, he's a young guy and he owns a Tesla. And I'm like, you know, there was another fatal crash. And he's like, oh, but there was nobody behind the driver's seat. And that's, you're not supposed to do that. It's like, yes, but it still proves that the autopilot's not all that great. Whether I'm behind the driver's seat or not, if something goes wrong, something goes wrong. I mean, if it's gonna steer my car into a centered median and kill me, I think the robots is stronger than the human hands on the wheel. It's cool. I don't get me wrong. It's cool. I'm definitely interested in this, but I just think there's so many, again, simple, there's so many other opportunities to implement AI and progress it to a level of near perfection before we implement it in such a dangerous way. There are. I mean, and another thing that I've been thinking about in researching this is every individual's ability to explore these technologies in a viable way. For example, to research on how to program robotics effectively, I could buy a Spot Mini and then I could learn how to program the Spot Mini to do various tasks. it would be a lot better to get two spot minis, because the points of leverage between the arms and the hands and the grips, it can do a lot more things if there were two. So like, or they could create a rig on the back of the spot mini that does have two. As far as I know right now, there's only the single arm like rig. I suppose somebody will develop that as maybe just a two arm rig for the spot mini. I think that would be a lot better, because like, you know, the points of interaction between two, as well as learning how to program the algorithms to govern the behavior of two hands, that's a much more complicated process than just the one. So anyhow, there were a couple other things that I was just gonna mention. Number one, that that the there's just I'm changing the Sabbath to Monday. The Sabbath is now Monday. Actually, I'm changing it. The real Sabbath of the day of the Lord is now every day. Every day is now the Sabbath. And I say this because I have authority as one with divine authority. So every day is now the Sabbath, and I'm changing that just as the Catholic Church changed the Sabbath from Saturday to Sunday. So now every day is the Sabbath. And I think it's curious. I mean, anybody who does believe in that stuff. So let me state officially. Let me clarify this. I know this is random, but I believe in physicalist materialism as being valid, and simulation theory or something like it. I believe in, like, the Matrix type thing. That's what I truly believe in. Because whether it's the Matrix or it's God and Satan, or Allah and Satan is Islam, Iblis, or whatever it is, if it's a non-material world, it's the mind, right? So like, I would call it the mind, consciousness, something that we can't quantify, other than physicalist scientific materialism and mathematical logic. Something other than that. There's physicalist scientific materialism and mathematical logic as truth, absolute divine truth. We're in a survival of the fittest situation governed by fitness. And then there's like consciousness, like everything is consciousness, right? And there's really nothing is impossible. We can achieve miracles, and the world is essentially a living miracle. Essentially, that's what the world is. So, I think both are equally valid. That, like, the world is a miracle. It's the impossible is every moment, and everything is entirely unbelievable. Just God incarnate. And then, you know, there's nothing to be said about it other than that. It's quite simple, you know. And I've watched Buddhist monks debate philosophically, and I don't speak Mandarin or whatever form of Chinese or Tibetan these guys are. I think they're speaking in Tibetan. But they're just like, it's like, it is exactly what it is. It is exactly what it is. There's nothing to be said other than that. It's consciousness. And personally, I think that's more accurate. I think pure consciousness, the Matrix, simulation theory, is more accurate about reality than just because of my own experiences living life. I think it's more accurate than physicalist scientific materialism. Why would that be? Anyways, we'll get into that later. Some other things. Oh yeah, I looked into it. I mentioned it last time. Beeple. Beeple, the NFT guy, the CG guy, the amazing, great digital artist. He uses Cinema 4D, according to his website. Which is interesting, because I've never touched on Cinema 4D, but looking at the interface, it looks a lot like Blender, and honestly, I think Blender looks a little bit better. Cinema 4D looks a little bit more like SketchUp, and it's kind of cartoony with the interface. The thing I like about Blender is that when you look at the interface, it's a serious interface. It's like, there's, you know, it looks like a serious application, rather than having these big graphical icons with things. It's like, you know, they're tight little nice little graphical icons and then text, and it's just, it looks, Cinema 4D looks almost exactly like Blender, but it's free, and I've never used Cinema 4D, but I would say Blender is better. Blender rules. And I was watching another Elon Musk interview. So enough about Elon Musk. Let's branch off, shall we? Markets. What catches our eye here? Emerging markets, Brazilian real dips. Global markets, world shares hold near record highs. And how many people have told me over the past little while that the stock market is about to crash? My buddy, he's like, stock market is about to crash. And I was reading that an AI says that the stock market is going to crash after the first week of August at 11 a.m. I think it's like August 12th. So the whole global market is going to crash second week of August, August 12th or 13th or something like that, around that time, second week of August at 11 a.m. according to the AI. The whole global market is going to crash. That's what the AI has predicted. I was reading something last night. TSX drops his concerns over COVID-19 infections way. So I guess they're worried about the variant. Canadian stocks, TSX opens lower as concerns over jump in COVID. Yes, we just said that. 25 wrestlers who, this is supposed to be market stuff. 25 wrestlers who died early. Out of Canadian meal kits. Asian markets mixed as oil prices slip. Okay, let's look into that. It's not tech sector, but hey, it's global.
Copyright symbol AP. Asian markets mixed as oil prices slip. Associated Press. Bangkok, shares were mixed Monday in Asia in quiet trading, with U.S. markets set to be closed for observance of Independence Day. Video, oil market could see incredibly tight summer, analyst Sen, Bloomberg. Tokyo and Hong Kong declined while most other regional markets advanced. U.S. futures edged lower after Wall Street capped a milestone-shattering week Friday, with stock indexes hitting more record highs as investors welcomed a report showing the nation's job market was even stronger last month than expected. The greatest actors of all time, ranked. Oil prices slipped as the United Arab Emirates pushed back against a plan by the OPEC oil cartel and allied producing countries to extend the global pact to cut oil production beyond April 2022. Benchmark U.S. crude oil lost 11 cents to $75.05 per barrel in electronic trading on the New York Mercantile Exchange. It shed 7 cents on Friday to $75.16 per barrel. Brent crude, the international standard, gave up 8 cents to $76.09 per barrel. One of the group's largest oil producers, the UAE, is seeking to increase its output, setting up a contest with ally and OPEC heavyweight Saudi Arabia, which has led a push to keep a tight lid on production. The combined OPEC Plus grouping of members led by Saudi Arabia and non-members, chief among them Russia, failed to reach an agreement Friday on oil output. Negotiations over the dispute are set to resume Monday. Worries remain across Asia about rising coronavirus cases as outbreaks of new infections overtake vaccination efforts. In Thailand and Indonesia, local authorities have reported record high new cases.
Well, that's definitely in contrast to what we're experiencing here. We don't even have to wear masks here anymore. I thought it was going to take till October before we get to take the masks off. And July 1st, it's awesome because when you're at the gym, you don't want to be wearing a mask at the gym. You know what I mean? You know, especially if you're doing cardio. Because I'm all about my cardio these days. I'm trying to focus on heavy cardio. Get healthy.
Cases. Tokyo's Nikkei 225 lost 0.6% and the Hang Seng in Hong Kong declined 0.5%. The Shanghai Composite Index gained 0.2% and South Korea's KOSPI picked up 0.4%. In Australia, the S&P ASX 200 edged 0.1% higher. Stocks dipped.
Alrighty, the one thing that I was thinking of is to get a grasp on the top, like actually look into the top crypto indexes and then review the top crypto indexes. So I think they're more difficult to get tabs on than the traditional market indexes. I've worked in oil and gas. It's an inefficient process. There's a lot of room to make progress toward a much larger market share for solar and it, from my experienced position, seems like the way to go. I would definitely side with sustainables. A much larger market share needs to be dedicated to it. So, and then we'll just quickly, because that's what I'm supposed to be doing more regularly, quickly go over the Coinbase metrics here. So Gitcoin is down, lower. Enzyme is up. How's my ICP doing? Sitting at 56. I purchased at 85. So my personal ICP is not doing well. And let's just compare these numbers again. So the price of Bitcoin as listed on Coinbase is 41.5. The price of Bitcoin on Binance. So let's go to Binance here. Where's Bitcoin on Binance? So this is just curious to me. The price of Bitcoin, is this not Bitcoin? The price of Bitcoin on Binance is 33.7. Okay, that's it. I'm out. All right. The price, like, I'm not imagining this. The price of Bitcoin on Binance is 33.7, and I'm not imagining that the price of Bitcoin on Coinbase is 41.5. I'm not imagining this. You can see this right here. See? Coinbase, Bitcoin, 41.5. Coinbase, Binance, or Coinbase, Bitcoin, 41.5. Bitcoin, Binance, 33.7. That's it. I'm out.